Here are this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss.
Now, I am on lower bandwidth and studio capabilities this week as rodents chewed through my Ethernet cables. I'm replacing them, and you might notice I've got a GitHub page open in front of me. It looks pretty interesting. Don't worry, we don't have to play with code. This can all be done inside Hugging Face. Okay, so how did I do that intro? I'm using a Hugging Face space called Live Portrait, where you upload a reference image like this. It's a whole video in the 1:1 aspect ratio, and then you'll upload an image over here. So I've chosen this one to animate, a simple portrait photo of me, and then you click Animate. And boom, within moments, you have this video.
Here are this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss.
It's a little bit freaky, I've got to admit, but the animations are actually really good.
Here are this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss.
And of course, you don't have to use your own reference video. Here's an example that they include. Let's animate this. And here's my newly generated AI video. Now, of course, if you want to test this out for yourself, go and use the links down below in the description. As you can see, it generates pretty complex facial movements, and you can download or share the video as you like. Let's do another example here with the famous Mona Lisa, and we'll go ahead and use this as our reference video here. So let's go ahead and animate and see what comes back. Find the link to this tool and everything else I mentioned in this video in the description down below, and subscribe for weekly updates on new AI tools. Okay, next up, we got a brand new model from OpenAI in the Playground. So if you log into platform.openai.com/playgrounds, which of course I'll link down below, you can use GPT-4o Mini. This is pretty cool. Now, in the API Playground, it's just the same as the ChatGPT interface. You can put in any prompt like this, create an informative article on the benefits of a plant-based diet, and GPT-4o Mini goes to work and gives you a very short article, as you would expect. Here's another prompt: write a blog post on the top 5 productivity tools for remote workers. And again, GPT-4o Mini is very fast and gives us Trello, Slack. And of course, if you run out of context, you can either increase your tokens here to make it larger so you get a larger output, or you can just simply type continue into the prompt box and on it goes. There you go, making more and more for your article with Zoom and so on. Now, if you wanted to, you can integrate GPT-4o Mini straight into LibreChat. It's the tool I use to bring all of my AI assistants together. And I've got another video on that. Go and watch that to learn how to install the ultimate AI tool for all of the large language models. Finally, for this mini roundup this week, I was on the AI Explored podcast with Michael Stelzner. Take a listen to this.
All right, face transplant. I can't not let you not talk about what the heck a face transplant. Give us the lowdown. What's the tools you use? And just be clear, what the heck you even mean by face transplant? Yeah.
This is all done using AI, and it is pretty much the final piece of the the creation. I've got this thumbnail. The person in it looks kind of like me because I've used Midjourney's character reference, but it's not me. So I now use a tool to just swap my face onto that. One of the easiest ways that I'd recommend, and this is the way I'm doing it right now, is go to a site. It's called replicate.com. And on there, they have all kinds of AI tools. But if you go to that site and type in face swap, you'll find a bunch of different free face swaps. And all you need to do to use this site is have a GitHub account, which I know sounds techie, but it's free to have a GitHub account. So have one of those, log in using GitHub, and you can use their face swap tools. Okay, here's a very brief summary of how I do thumbnails for my YouTube videos. First, I go into Discord and use Midjourney to make something that looks pretty realistic. But it's not quite me, so I drop it into an online face swapper. You'll find links for these down below. And then I do the final edits and touch-ups in Adobe Photoshop, but you can just as easily do this stuff in Adobe Express. And again, I'll link a deeper tutorial on face swapping and AI thumbnail creation down below and on your screen now. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like to get these updates weekly, make sure to subscribe to my weekly AI tools newsletter. It's in the links down below.